First of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. But I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs. So I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular. In other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hello lovely Aquarius, this is your July reading, July 2017, your Angelscope, Tarotscope and Astrological Overview. So you have got this month the emphasis on the 6th house for most of July, because yes, Cancer is your 6th house on your 6th house cusp. So we are going to first of all look at, so that's basically about your day-to-day reality, okay? And so what it means is that you need to look at where your day-to-day reality is or is not supporting your emotional sense of fulfillment, well-being and safety and happiness. Okay, so where is it that you are being forced to push yourself too hard on a day-to-day basis? Where is it that that is connected with old childhood patterns? So in other words, where are you feeling that you have to work that hard to prove yourself? Why is it taking so much effort maybe for you to just fulfill the basic needs that you have in terms of your material reality? Your day-to-day work, your day-to-day routines and experiences, it could even involve your health. So is your health being impacted by your work at the moment? All of those aspects are ruled by the 6th house. So we are asking, what is for your highest experience in your day-to-day reality and your greatest health? We're not only focusing on those things, but just to give us a guide, what do we need to tell Aquarians for the month of July for their greatest, highest good and health and happiness? Right, I thought that was where I needed to stop. So we'll do the Celtic cross first. So love begins an outpouring of emotion, an outpouring of possibility, an outpouring of love. So it looks as if your day-to-day reality is about to be transformed with love. So it could be that you start giving yourself more love. It could be that there's a relationship around you that makes you feel supported and loved. It could be new love coming in that gives you a strong sense of Okay, maybe it's not perfect, maybe your day-to-day reality isn't perfect in terms of work, but at least you have something nice to come home to, something very supportive, something that makes you feel better. And it could just be that this is a channel of love that's opening up, that's allowing you to feel love and support from spirit. Either way, it's going to be, July is going to be a month when you start to feel the love, so to speak, okay? It's been a long time coming for you because it feels as if it's been a bit of hard graft and a bit of a long road. So let's just see what else. What crosses that love? Love begins and prosperity begins. Well, love is prosperity, love is abundance, but I do feel that it's actually, look, you've got all the aces there. I mean, that's just talk about a win. That's the ace. You've got the Ace of Cups in the traditional deck. And you've got the Ace of Pentacles, so it's like the love in your life is supporting you to go on to greater prosperity, better things, new beginnings. It feels as if there could be a new job or a new work situation or a new possibility at least coming in, or some kind of a new win that makes you feel like, okay, right, this is going to give me a bit of a start, a better sort of start over. That's where you are, right at the beginning of the energy as we move into July, or as we move into the sign of Cancer, if you like, so from the end of June onwards and through July. Right, okay, so where are we? Alliances, partnerships and alliances, that's great. Isn't it interesting that we're talking about day-to-day reality for you and it's all about partnerships and love? So there's a possibility for you to actually connect with someone. Connect with someone that you know, or someone that whose work you respect, or just to feel that safety and security in a partnership to the extent where you actually begin to reconsider your day-to-day reality. Maybe consider a job change, maybe consider a new change of path because you feel supported in that, because you feel you have someone around you who allows you to be exactly who you are, regardless of what that might mean. Or because you are aware of a new partnership that comes in that makes you want to dream bigger, dream better, dream of a better reality for yourself in terms of what you do every day. Okay. Patience and planning. This card's coming up a lot today. So you've had to put some thought into this before now because it feels as if there's something on the wind, that change is inevitable, change is on the way anyway. So it feels as if you've actually been planning something. You've been planning something that's going to give you this new beginning. And again, it looks as if you've had a lot of support around that planning. So you're not on your own in any of this, and that's why it's more likely to succeed, which is great. There's two pillars as well as really standing out there, standing side by side, two pillars there. Isn't that great? Okay, so let's see what energy you're moving out of. So, and that's your foundation, you know? So that's going to support anything, isn't it? Okay, accelerated motion. Things happening very quickly. So it could be that things change has started to happen very quickly, or you very quickly thought to yourself, right, I can't do this anymore. This something's got to change. Something's got to change in my daily reality. It could be a really good positive change coming in and you can hardly believe it. Okay, so this is the energy that you're just moving out of as you come into July. Just like suddenly things picking up really quickly and accelerating at the end of June, and it's like, okay, it's time to make a change. And it's time to embrace this new beginning. Emotional withdrawal. Be careful that you don't get overwhelmed. So looking at these two eights here, definitely a time for things to be coming to an end, coming to completion. However, it's not necessary. In fact, you do need some healing because, again, this is the sixth house, it's all about health and healing. So if you need to withdraw a little bit in order to find your balance again and get the healing that you need, that's absolutely fine. I feel that's absolutely fine for you in this context because you do tend to push yourself, and you've been in a period of having to push and push and push. And it almost feels as if, you know, when you get to the point where things start speeding up and therefore you make a decision to either go with it or not, once you've decided, yes, I'm going to go with the change, then you've got like a period of a couple of weeks or something. I know that's very specific, but it's that kind of feeling or energy to just heal your wounds and prepare for the next phase that you go into. So that's all looking very good. So there's been a lot of suffering in silence, a lot of being overburdened, being asked to carry out too many tasks, having too many people's work on your shoulders. It's not all yours. It's not all stuff that you should be asked to do. If that's your day-to-day work reality, then of course something needs to change. And you've just been sort of putting up with it and just thinking, well, you know, I've got to do this because that's basically what it is. But it feels as if you're this sense of suffering in silence is also a way of not taking care of yourself, excuse me, and you're beginning to realise that in order for you to feel more emotionally satisfied and supported and safe, you're going to have to speak up. In your environment, there's transformation. So you have set the wheels in motion for not settling for less than you deserve. Which is great. So your daily reality is in a stage of transformation at this time. There is no doubt about it, because it has to, because you can't just keep chipping away in the way that you've been doing when you need a broader sweep to happen. And you also will be getting some help with that. So definitely a time to form alliances, definitely a time to see yourself as part of a whole, a collective, rather than just one person kind of ploughing away. Okay. And it's really funny because I'm getting through this reading really quickly, or it seems that way, because the energy is quite fast. So things are moving quite fast. Triumphant success you're hoping for, of course. So there's some kind of possibly some kind of dispute or something that you're waiting to hear about, something that will bring justice in this situation. And then you've got 1-1-1, you've got 3 1s there, so it's all pointing to a lot of new beginnings, a lot of possibility of complete sweep of change, and of you being able to look back and say, right, that point in my life was huge. So many things changed for me at that point in my life. That's how I've become this person. So looking a few years down the line, it's a really, really important time. So you need to embrace it, embrace that change, and don't resist it. Try not to resist it. Trapped in fear, let's pick another one. Rejoice in celebration. Okay, so we've got another 8 here. 3 8, definitely time for change, but maybe you don't necessarily want change. Aquarius is a fixed sign. They don't necessarily like things to be upset. They can go plodding on, plodding on, plodding on forever, just fixed and dutiful and just continuing on. And even though they're very maverick and very sort of innovative and, you know, kind of leading edge, there is a side of them that can be very sort of, oh well, you know, this is just what I've got to do, I've just got to keep doing it, I've just got to get my head down, it's going to be fine. But if you carry on like that and you refuse to embrace the changes happening, you will end up feeling trapped, okay? So the universe is giving you an opportunity to break free, I feel, in a sense. And I'm not telling you what to do, Spirit are not telling you what to do, but there are two paths before you at this time, and the wisest path might be the new and the uncharted territory, possibly. Let's pick one more card for you there. Material and spiritual prosperity. Great. So don't doubt yourself, Aquarius. I know you've been stuck, some of you, in a very small vision of your life for a long time, but remember that you are a visionary. You are a visionary. And with all this talk of vision, my guys are talking about vision and visionary. I actually feel there's some third eye opening as well. I feel that you could be becoming more psychic recently, and you're having visions, not just visions of in terms of, oh, that might be a good idea, but actually Spirit feeding you new ideas and saying, you know, you could probably make a success of this if you tried. Forget about past failures, receive the input that's coming to you from Spirit, and start moving towards a new consciousness in terms of how you see yourself and what you may or may not be able to succeed at doing. You've had success, because most Aquarians end up being notable people, let's just say, but you've still got a long way to go, okay, in terms of what you allow yourself to have, to be, do and have. Okay, and so break out of restrictions now. This is a good time. It's ripe. With all these ones and all these eights, you know, it's time. It's time. So let's just see what we get from the oracle cards. And I feel like I want to clear the decks there, because usually I put the oracle cards on top of the tarot, but now I'm clearing the decks. It's like a clean sweep. I don't know why I did that, but I know that everything I do when I'm in this space, opened up and receiving from spirit, means something. So clear the decks. It's time to clear the decks. So past, present and future. Rest. Okay, so you're coming out of a period of rest. You've been working yourself into the ground. It says here you've been working hard, take a nap, get some rest. So you may be coming out of this energy. This energy may still come and go. You might have had to do a lot more rest than you like to do in order to restabilize yourself, rebalance yourself, and even do a bit of physical healing. And you know, now you're emerging. It looks like a very nurturing space as well. It's almost womb-like, isn't it? It's like little baby mermaid, all cocooned and safe. And it's like, so it feels as if you've been quite vulnerable in some respects, almost as if, I don't want to say you've been under attack, but it's like you've had to withdraw and go inside and rest yourself and heal yourself deeply and find your inner resources. And now you're coming into the kind of, back into the kind of Aquarian energy that we're used to, where you're vibing with the universe, where you're in sync, where synchronicities are starting to happen. This is what you're going to start to see in July, much more of this, where your faith has been is going to be rewarded. And it says your prayers and questions are being answered by synchronistic events. So notice coincidences in July. Notice little signs that the universe is scattering around you, that your guides are showing you. Notice repeating number patterns. Notice, you know, people that you meet who just happen to mention something in conversation that brings you back to a path that you might have been afraid to embrace. Notice people coming back into your life, old people who are of a particular energy or time or a phase of better self-belief. Notice things. Notice them in order to increase their flow, and also notice them in order to see the messages that they're giving you. And you're moving into a time where you're going to be receiving help from heaven. So this could be deceased loved ones who are helping to guide you because they have concern for you. And remember, Cancer is very much about healing the past, healing childhood wounds. So while the sun's in Cancer, a lot of us will be doing that healing work and looking at, well, why is this area of my life the way that it is? How can I heal that? So it may be that there's someone in spirit who was a part of your childhood, who saw you go through certain challenges as a child, who is aware of how you have certain patterns that lead you to limit yourself in this particular way, and is helping you to heal that and to get over it now once and for all, so that you can have some of the goodies that are waiting to come to you. I've got a sense of, I'm being drawn to the stomach area as well, and that is not typical for Aquarius. That's more the Virgo area for weakness. Well, let's not put that energy out there, but I feel that for some Aquarians there's been a lot of stress, and there have been digestive issues as a result, or tension and anxiety in the stomach area. And I also want to let you know that you will receive help for that as well, okay? If you give yourself time and space to heal. For others, it's all up in the chest, because I feel a bit breathless as well. But I feel that with Aquarians, there's just been a general impact on the body of some of the stresses that you've been asked to take on recently. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, so accept heaven's help. Let's pick one more, because sometimes when people get a card like that, they think, oh, is that it? Isn't it saying that I'm going to have a brilliant future? Let's see what else there is. Ready, set, go. Now is the perfect moment to dive in and embrace your heart's desire. So Aquarius, you know what you have to do. You know what you really, 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 really want to be doing with your life and with your time and with your day-to-day reality in your work. You know why you're blocked. You know why your creativity isn't flowing. You know why you're not happy, and you know why you've been stressed out. And I know this isn't going to apply to all Aquarians. I know some of you will say, oh, everything's great. But for those who are in that situation where things are just about to break and offer you an opportunity to take a new direction, July could be the turning point for you in doing that, and you are being encouraged to go, go, go. Set your sights higher. Look at that. What could possibly be better? You need to be working fewer hours for more money, for a start. Sorry, that just came in. And you need to be embracing the higher vision of your life overall. So fewer hours so that you have more time to embrace your true calling. That's my feeling. Okay, and I'm going to just pick one of the heart cards as well, because I feel like Aquarius needs it. And I'm being drawn over here towards turquoise. Let's see. Oops. Guilt. Okay. You do not need another's approval to feel worthy of love. Regardless of what you've done or what you think you've failed to do from your soul's perspective, there's neither right nor wrong. Now to me, again, this is healing childhood wounds and issues. Every experience in life is here to help you expand your awareness of love so that you may embrace ever greater spheres of wisdom. You've done nothing wrong, okay? Aquarius, let yourself off the hook now and please move into the beautiful divine future that's calling you to your true calling. And have a fantastic July. Have a great time with all of this. It's all fun, it's all experimentation. I know it's not necessarily been feeling like fun, but the opportunity is there now to make change. Just grab it. And if you want to book a private reading with me, the links are all below the video. Have a fantastic July, and I'll see you again in August. Take care. Bye.